ex-NFL player attacks his mother and the mother of his child. This is so sad. Put him up. According to the allegation, the former Jets first round pick, Darron Lee, was arrested in Ohio on Monday. He's accused of beating his own mother and then the mother of his 2-year-old son. The irony is unbelievable as to why the mother was even there. According to Franklin County Sheriff's records, Lee is charged with 2 counts of misdemeanor assault, 2 counts of misdemeanor domestic violence. Lindsay McGlone, the mother of Lee's son, reportedly called police in Dublin, Ohio on Monday afternoon and said Lee was assaulting his mother, Candace Lee. After hearing Candace screaming upstairs, Lindsay reportedly told police she went up, saw Candace lying on her back with Mr. Lee over top of her with raised fist. Candace Lee reportedly told police that she came to the house because Lindsay said she did not feel safe in the home with Darron Lee. Candace said her son was lying on the floor in an upstairs bedroom and that he became incensed when she told him he had to leave the house, allegedly screaming at her, pushing her against the wall, throwing her to the ground, punching her in the face. She was transported to the hospital with head pain and swelling in one cheek. Lindsay also accused Lee of previous domestic violence incidents from last October, saying the ex-Jet became violent with her when he suspected her of cheating. Lindsay told police that Lee got on top of her in the bed, threatened her that he would kill her and their child. She also claimed that he punched a pillow on the side of her and grabbed her throat. Lindsay told police that Lee threw a phone against the wall so hard that it bounced off, hit her in the head, and made her ear bleed. The former linebacker was also accused of grabbing Lindsay by the neck, swinging her to the ground. Lee reportedly told police that she struck him in the face during the October incident and denied having thrown an object at her or grabbing her neck. Police charged Lee in connection with the incident after they looked at photos from the injuries and the broken phone, and a diary entry from the day of the alleged altercation. For someone to engage in this level of violence against anyone inside of a home, obviously, this is not a sustainable situation. The person needs to be outside of that home, in jail, hopefully getting help to return back to society. But this has a different twist to it, AB. According to the mama, he jumped on his own mother in the process of jumping on someone else. And the reason the mother is there is because the mother of his child was in fear and wanted some stopgap. And listen, some people may say, well, why wouldn't you just leave? Why would you call the mother? Because you would assume the mother can have a level of control over her child, especially if they have a good relationship. So I'm sure that was part of the reasoning behind that call. But damn, AB, thoughts?
Yeah, so first and foremost, we probably shouldn't make any type of assumptions when it comes to domestic violence victims, because you just never know what that situation entails and why the victim made the decision that they made. But in this case, we see that people who are violent domestically seem to recidivate more than other criminals, right? And so I think we should not just look at it as a crime, but look at it as what helps, like what services can we provide to help this population of people? Because why do you think that expressing yourself in this way is the appropriate manner to resolve a conflict? Yeah. Because that's what you have here. I hope that both parties, both victims that were harmed, can get some sort of help and services. But I also hope that there is help and service for this young man and some sort of healing, because this is dangerous. And this is something that we see in our communities a lot of times. And we are seeing a lot of athletes be responsible for domestic violence and being in these domestic disputes. And so I don't know if it's the sports or if it's the injuries or what it is, but there definitely needs to be more investigation into why we continue to see this type of behavior from individuals who are participating in sports.
Well said.